Let's go. Time is money.
Economic upswing allowed the railroad to grow steadily, and as settlements suddenly appeared on the timetables, which until now had been in the middle of nowhere, the country had grown closer. Soon, entrepreneurial vanities and greed fueled the railroad tycoons' first rivalries for lucrative routes and connections. Meanwhile, the Mississippi formed a border between the vibrant centers in the east on the one side and the untapped settlements and new markets in the west on the other. Yet technological innovation, unbroken pioneering spirit, and a good nose for business would soon bring down this barrier as well and drive the triumphant procession of the railroad on unimpeded.
So, you're the crazy one who wants to build the transcontinental route. You are aware that there have already been many dreamers who have all failed spectacularly, and you think that that won't be the case for you. Oh, I don't want to destroy your dreams, of course. Give it a try. My name is Cornelius Vanderbilt. The Cornelius Vanderbilt. I'm sure you've heard of me. I'm not so optimistic about the future of the railroad and prefer to invest in waterways, but you never know. So I'm interested in what goals you are pursuing.
My dear, are we competing with each other again? That is a nice surprise. Things might not have gone so well for me last time, but I've got more up my sleeve this time. Some people with money find it difficult to resist me, if you follow my meaning. So, good luck, even if you're not going to have much of that.
Top hat and tails suit you. But I'm happy I don't have to wear such things. I'm sure we'll have lots of fun, but you need to be cautious of the nice lady, otherwise she'll just roll you over. But if we work together, luck will be on our side.
a station here. How carefully did you consider that?
I heard your target is Omaha. You can forget that. Or is the train supposed to fly over the Mississippi? Negotiations over a bridge are ongoing, but that's a long story. Sure, the network is somewhat patchy in the east, and you could take care of Toledo and the other cities first. But is it really worth establishing a network there?
Thank you.
Well, it didn't interest me, but it's nice that you've won something for a change.
How sweet! You have a new toy. show you how it's done.
You're constantly expanding your business, huh? Chin up, sweetie. There's no such thing as a bad press. Chin up, sweetie. There's no such thing as a bad press.
Who reads the papers these days anyway?
Thank you. Thank you.
little competition creates business, so my new station won't do any harm. It's probably just another one of your little mistakes, but could it be that you just placed a bid?
You do know that the two rails have to run parallel to each other, right? Looks pretty amateurish to me.
I wanted to help you reduce your monthly labor costs.
I must admit the results speak for themselves. This rail network is impressive.
A station here? How carefully did you consider that?
I started out with a little sailboat. I used this to ferry passengers and goods between Staten Island and Manhattan. That's how I built my reputation, and yes, that's also how I got my title Commodore. I was 16 years old at the time. I see you've managed to expand your rail network in the East. That's more than I expected of you. I hear the bridge over the Mississippi has been approved. However, the Mississippi is a land border, and we must respect it. Constructing a bridge over it might be doable, but it's a huge amount of work. Otherwise, you'd have to supply the construction site at Rock Island with materials and build another line there just for that. That's really not worth it. When I first started out, nobody took me seriously. Cornelius, whose family of Dutch farmers emigrated to America, but I showed them all.
Thank you.